Hey guys, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to run any OpenAI model just like if you were running any other open source model on Microsoft Azure. Not only that, but we will also build and deploy our own custom RAG web application that you can use to chat with your own private documents without any code. Let's get started. Alright, first of all, for those who don't know, running models on Azure OpenAI actually has a couple major benefits. Azure OpenAI is fully controlled by Microsoft, which means that they host OpenAI models in their own secure environment. This means that they do not interact with any of the services operated by OpenAI. And secondly, Azure OpenAI has much higher token limits than the default OpenAI API. For example, for GPT-4, the starting tier at OpenAI is only 10k tokens per minute, which is a huge problem for many of my clients. However, for Microsoft Azure, this token limit actually starts at 80k, which is orders of magnitude higher. So now let's deploy our first OpenAI model on Microsoft Azure. I recommend following this tutorial with me right now step by step and not delaying it for later because it takes a few days for your account to get approved. Okay, the first thing you need to do is create a new Microsoft Azure account. Search for Microsoft Azure portal in Google, open the first link and then click sign up. You should get a $200 credit after you fill out the onboarding form. After you have logged into Azure, search for the OpenAI service in the search bar on top. Click Create Azure OpenAI and then create a new resource. Fill out the next form as early as possible because, as I said, it takes at least a few days to get approved. Somewhere in the middle of the form, you will be required to enter your subscription ID, which you can find again in the search bar if you search for subscriptions. After you have been approved, you can go to Azure OpenAI and enable this service. Then create a new instance, select your subscription and create a new resource group if you don't have any. For the region, I recommend selecting East US 2 if you need to have access to GPT-4. Then name your resource, select the standard pricing tier and then click Next. On the next page, select all networks, then click Next again and click Create. After your deployment has been initialized, you can click on Go to Resource and proceed with creating your first model. To do so, click on the Explore button on the same page. Make sure to open it in a new tab, then go to Azure OpenAI Studio, then click Deployments and click Create New Deployment. You can select any model available on OpenAI if you are in the right region. Make sure to also select model version 0613 if you want to have function calling feature enabled. And then in advanced settings, you can actually control your token per minute rate limit, which you can increase all the way up to 80k tokens for GPT-4 and 300k tokens for GPT-3.5. For this tutorial, we will simply use GPT-3.5 16k model with 0613 version. I prefer to set the name of the deployment to the model name. Click Create. Now, already we can test it out in the Python notebook, which you can find in the description below. The great thing about Azure OpenAI is that you can use the same OpenAI package that you normally use and switch with just one line of code. So let's install OpenAI, import it and then define API type parameter as Azure. Your API base and API key you can find in Keys and Endpoint tab on Azure OpenAI resource on the left. Run this cell, copy the values and paste them below. Now you can call your model in the same way as you would call the OpenAI API, with the only difference being that instead of the model parameter, you need to use the engine parameter and insert your deployment name. Now run this cell and you should already have your first completely private OpenAI completion that runs exclusively on your own private OpenAI model instance on Azure. However, in this tutorial, we will take it a step further and actually create a whole private chat with your documents shareable web application without any code on Azure OpenAI Studio. For this web app, we'll actually have to create another model, which as you might have guessed, the one and only embedding ADA 002 model. So go through the same process for creating the model deployment as I showed you earlier, leave the default settings and click Create. Now, find chat under Playground tab on the left. Enter your system message, add examples if required and click on Add your data tab. Click Add a data source and select Upload files. Then click on Create a new Azure Blob storage, select a resource group and storage account name, then click Review and click Create. Then go back to the previous tab and repeat the same process for the cognitive search resource, except this time make sure to select the basic pricing tier because the free tier does not support semantic search, which is the most appropriate option for RAG chatbots. Nevertheless, the $200 quota that you have been given should be more than enough. Now, click on Review plus Create and click Create. After it's deployed, go back to the previous tab, select your blob storage and the Azure Cognitive Search resources that you have just created. Enable course if prompted, then enter your new index name, click Add Vector Search to this resource, and also select the embedding model below. Click on Next and drag and drop your own files. It accepts all of the most common textual formats, including PDF, doc, TXT, HTML, and even Markdown. I'm going to upload two recent AI research papers for MemGPT and AutoGen. Then I'm going to click on Upload Files and then click Next. For the search type, you can actually select not just vector, but vector plus keyword, which is something that I have not seen in any other vector databases. This can actually be quite useful because I personally had a couple of projects where we required some basic keyword searches, but since PineCon does not support this type of search, we had to re-upload our whole index to another platform called Algolia. Still, for this demo, we can just use the plain vector search and click Next. Then, click Save and Close and wait until the ingestion process is complete. After it's done, you can click on Deploy in the top right corner and select a new web app. I'm going to name my web app Research Paper OpenAI. Select the subscription, free pricing tier, enable chat history, and click Deploy. Now close this model, and in your notifications, you should now see that the app is being deployed. Once it's done, you will receive a notification with a link. You can also find your web app if you search for app services in the top bar. Now, let's go ahead and test it out. Let's start with a basic question like, what is MemGPT and how does it work? As you can see, the model easily answers the question and also provides clickable references, which is pretty convenient. Now, let's try a more complex question. How would I use AutoGen in production? Okay, even though AI answers the question, it didn't really pay attention to the word production. And personally, I don't think any businesses right now would ever allow anything like this to run in their production environments. However, if you do use AutoGen in production, please let me know in the comments. And finally, let's see how we combine MemGPT and AutoGen together. Okay, cool, so it actually did reference both files, which is exactly what we want. You can check out the previews if you click on the references. And also, don't forget that you can view the chat history in the top right corner. So, this was a great example of a service that you can offer as an AI developer, because not a lot of businesses know that you can create an application like this on Microsoft Azure, and even fewer businesses know how to do this themselves. And if you want to learn more of what AI developer's job actually entails and why I believe it will be one of the most sought after jobs of the next decade, make sure to check out my previous video here where I compare it to the more traditional position of a machine learning engineer. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.